with Fleet.
Hey, you got room for a couple loaded 30s?
Hot oil? Heaters? No, we're full on heaters right now, but someone may leave today.
All right, appreciate it, man.
All right, I'm going to put you down, though.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Okay. Bemir Bobcat, hello. Bemir Bobcat. Good morning. Pea soup today. Looks good. It's nice. It's clear. Really clear today, Doc. I expect a mass exodus of boats today. I'm sure of it. Oh, we already had two leave. And I'm going to get another one out right now. Boat painted and the head cleaned. Hello, Cactus Jack. leave me gone for good or just off the boat? Who's that? Leave me? Leave me. Who's leave? Who are you talking about? Who are you talking about? Leave, does that mean leave me gone for good or just off the boat? Leave, does that mean? Oh, when I said one boat's leaving, one barge is leaving? You said you have two leave. Oh, no. I'm talking about barges. Two barges just left. Two loads left. And I'm going to take one barge out now. Buffalo Fleet?
Hey, good morning. This is Simon on the Kuchata.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Captain, do you guys have a fuel flat or something like that?
Yeah, we have a fuel barge, yeah.
Oh, okay. I want to get fuel to my boat and my barges.
You in the fleet right now?
Yes, I'm on the Kuchata.
Let me see where your barges are at. Where are you at in there?
I'm on the outside. On the empties.
Oh, you have empty. Yeah, I can't bring the flat out to the empty fleet because that's too much weight on those on those eight empties.
Okay.
Let me see. Unless you push in on it on the side while we're doing it, because if a ship passes, it's going to tear that whole fleet off.
Yeah. Well, unless we can get the boat, we can get some fuel on the boat.
Yeah. I mean, how much fuel you need on your barges?
I don't need much. They take what? I got a couple of thousand on each barge.
Yeah, y'all get a PO number for that? Usually for when y'all get the fuel?
No, we don't use PO numbers. We just go straight.
Oh, it just goes, we just put your name for the PO number?
Yeah, for Canal Barge.
Yeah, and the name of the boat.
Yes.
Yeah, are you leaving? Or you'll be going somewhere after? Or are you staying in the fleet?
No, I'm supposed to load over here Monday.
Okay. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out how we can... Yeah, because, man, they got eight empties or seven empties on that fleet, on that tier.
We can do it later, tomorrow, whenever we can.
Yeah, let me figure out how we'll do it, and I'll get back with you on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Sure.
Yeah, because if we put the barge out there on those empties, the weight of that, I'd have to have you pushing in on it on the outside, because the ship's passing and it'll tear that spud off, tear the wires and lines because of the weight.
Okay.
And usually when we're loaded, once y'all loaded is when we usually do the fuel, fill them up.
Yeah.
When y'all in the loaded fleet.
At least we can go and fuel the barge. I mean the boat.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah. We'll get back with you, and we could work something out.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate that.
All right. Oh, Buffalo Fleet, can I help you? Good morning, Pill Billy. Buffalo Fleet, can I help you? This is Buffalo Fleet, home of the Buffalo Fleet. How can I help you? Can I take your order? Can I take your order? Why isn't my tablet coming on, man? Oh, now it's on. We usually pump them barges once they're full and in the loaded fleet. You know, he wants to fill them now while they're empty. I don't know. If I get him to bring his barges to us, it's a lot easier. Yeah, I'm fixing to give him a call on the phone. He was going to see about getting you out.
Yeah,
Yeah, I'm gonna give him a call on the I'll call him on the phone.
Alright, buddy.
Azeal. Or is it Azeid?
Okay, let's call Azeal.
Good morning to you. How you say your name? Is it is that an ID? Is that ID or LD? ID. Azeid? Fiji Warrior, good morning to you. At it early, yep. I was waiting for the call because I knew it was coming. Let me call this boat so we can get this party started. Hey, so y'all working 12s on there? I know, if you still on there and backwatch, god damn.
I know, dude. I can connect you about watches.
I know, man. Well, we gotta get that Scott Camp out, so we're gonna perk you up now and see if you can help me out.
Oh yeah, we're already cooked up. We're looking to take off and shoot that dive right there turning the bottom and smoke is going out like 2.7 something like that, so it's rolling out good.
Yeah, okay, so you're gonna hold off before you leave?
Yeah.
Alright, well I'll go ahead and see if you help me get, he's gotta get one barge out. We'll get him out and push it back in.
Alright, well I'll be on 76 with you, and like I said, I'm already fired up, so just let me know what you need.
Alrighty then.
Yeah,
you. See you in a little bit. That's my friend. I know that dude. We hang out sometimes. We worked together before.
He's my friend. That's my friend.
Oh man, we're gonna buffer watch. We're probably gonna buffer today. I hope not, but shit. Are the mermaids out this early? The mermaids and the mermen. Whew, that sun is some kind of bright. Let me tell you about it. We had 10 loaded barges up there at Dock 42, and 8 of them were just waiting for the weather to clear. Now they're saying the current's so strong out there, they're going to have to probably hold up a little longer. That current is smoking. How about you, Scott Camp? Which one? Okay, yeah, I saw you on the thing and on the computer and you was by the bank, but then now I see where you're at. Yeah, Brianna Elizabeth's already cranked up.
No, yeah, I'm going to go. You can get on the bond here, so I'm going to just push in on the next gear up, pull them out far enough to get that one out, and I'll back it down to 2-tier.
You got to make up on the other end. We can pull it out and get you made up on that end and hold it out there or something.
Yeah, that's fine. That's what I'm planning on. I'll just pull it out and then get made up on that one end, and then I'll back it down to 2-tier and get out of y'all's way.
Oh, yeah, okay. I'll see what you say. Roger that. You got somebody on the barge right now?
I don't, sir. Drop them off over there.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I guess, I mean, to maybe help, you know, break it down and all that stuff. But yeah, we're going to get over there and get a headline on it and get you on out.
No.
Better put your man on there and help. Come on now. Good morning, James. So good to see the sun. We haven't had it out for about a week and a half now. I know that's right. And now look, it's going to get covered up by the clouds. What's really going on here? It isn't supposed to be any rain today, but they got some dark clouds behind me. Boy, that wind's blowing though. Ooh, that wind's blowing right now. That wind is a blowing. I got breakfast sausage this morning. Mmm, delicious. Jimmy Dean. It's nice and juicy. No fun today, that's no fun. I know fog today, that's no fun. Hey! It's fun for me. Watch your mouth, TBDH. You say that, we might get some fog. Push two back in. Real easy. I like when that happens. I like it. There, y'all want to start breaking it down between y'all two barges, and we'll soft line it between the Brianna's and yours. Get it ready. What was this email? We just got a something. Morning, guys. Looks like we have Coast Guard inspection on the 3058, February 8th. Wait a minute. Okay, so hold on a minute. February 8th. Let's plan on having the barge on the Finger Pier on the 7th for a bit so Ray can prep for inspection. We can play it by ear as far as fueling tows go. Should be finished by noon on the 8th. Ooh, guess what? I ain't gonna be on here for that. Whoop whoop! Put y'all over here. going to be over here. All the action.
On the inside was flopping around for a minute.
All right, Rob, you're holding 35 below tier 1.
said.
That's what she was saying.
Yeah, the scarab. No, he's still at the dock over there. He's still at 42. He's supposed to leave today. He said he was. Hands full, can't answer that phone. I wonder if that captain is new to pushing old the way he was so scared. He was an older guy. I think he's had his license a while. I think he's just careful. And I guess that's all I can figure, man. He was just careful. Like he's afraid the barges touch him would cause a spark. You get called this morning?
Yeah, it's okay. I'm gonna call. I'll be the next one.
Kaylin Nicole. Kaylin Nicole. Ah, damn, where's he at? Where the hell's he at? You said at 38, 06, and 12?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Roger. That. Those barges you got there, y'all. No one's gonna. I guess they're gonna stop the heaters.
Yeah, they ain't built to watch for now.
Okay, Roger. That.
Nothing. Go ahead and turn me loose off that red top.
Going on the forehead, on the bow.
All right, they're gonna about to. They're about to back out. Let's go. Let's get it. Robert's a good cat, bro. He's holding that barge like right where it needs to be. On this boat behind me, behind y'all?
Be that, safe, man, be safe.
The one that's helping? Did we call you 820? That's what I'm calling it, 820. See, I told you, everybody wants to leave now. That other boat's ready to leave. So we got another one to go do. Let me call that Woody while we got a minute. Let me call Woody. Hey, I had my hands full for a minute there while you were calling.
I figured you'd be busy. I said, well, you're letting great five more times. Figured you'd be busy with your hands up. Do you know?
What's that?
Usually when I have to ring
about 4 times,
I'll be very, very busy, so I'll wait and
sleep a
message. But anyway, my question is that I'm outbound, outbound, and I got a...
Yeah, Elizabeth,
you're on 36. Mark, you said 32, but it was 33, so it's a bit.
Yes. Yes.
I just want to make sure what he did that.
Okay.
All right, we'll get back with you a little later on. I'm about to come and help you.
All right, sounds good.
Thank you.
Okay, bye. Okay, Roger. Yeah, I was on the phone with about that. Yeah, I'm a... See, got a knuckled in there, Robert.
Another
yeah, man, he's pretty good. He's pretty good, Cap. I'm gonna tell him that. I'm telling him that too. Cause that Spirit.
75 wide on the side.
This boat over here named the Spirit. Oh my God.
75.
That cab on the Spirit, man, it's hard working with him trying to put some barges in. Ooh, it's rough. I basically had to pin my end, touch my end up, and then push the rest of the barges in myself. He said he couldn't do it. His boat wouldn't kick him over for some reason. I don't know. Maybe it was his boat. Maybe. It might have been his boat. Alright, I'll start slowing it down a little bit for you. Slow it on down. I was like, man, something don't look right there.
You're about 30, 25 wide down on the stern.
I was like, something don't look right. We're only pushing, we only took one barge out. That's what don't
look right. Touched up about 10.
How I look on the bow there, Tom?
Got about 12 feet to touch.
Bill, Coconut Hall. Mayor accidentally went to the gay bar for beer. He did. That wasn't an accident. Hey, Captain, hope you're well. Hello, AI Bill. Morning, friends. I think this is the first time I've been in when you're on the water. Well, hello, Ratsky. We are doing our thing. I'm fixing to go. We just took one barge out. So this guy right here just left with his one barge. We put these back. Now I gotta get these two black barges here out. That boat right here is gonna take them two barges out of here. He said he's gonna bring you. Michael said, not without him. I haven't been in them. I know where they are. I haven't been in them. I'm just saying, I know where they are. I've walked by them before. Looks like, sure. I think our last time I watched, there was a heavy fall.
Oh, I appreciate you guys' help.
Hey, thank you too, man. Let me know when you're ready, I guess, if you want to, when you're ready. There'll be a minute.
Yeah, I'm just going to hold up, dude. I don't really see anybody else moving with empty and things. Still getting up to 30 miles, so I don't have to deal with that. And that tire's there bothering me.
Hey, Roger. All right, we're going to go grab these other two out real quick.
All right. Thank you.
Boiled eggs is delicious. Sure. Say they are on your radar. You know where they are? On my radar. I got it. I've passed in front of them before. They play great music.
Fall back, looks like we came here a little bit.
That'd be all right. How about you, Kashada? Kashada.
Louisiana, come in.
Hey, Cap, we're going to get that boat on the inside of you out. That Caitlin Nicole has to get his barges out. If I'll get on the outside if you want to give me a hand with the forward reverse and get them all full pulled out.
Okay, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Said nope, no, you don't. God dang cables, man. Let me see if he wants to push out. About you, Caitlin Nicole, you heading inbound, right?
Yeah, roger.
Alright, we'll pull you out far enough to have you push on. We'll get a little twist on and have you push out.
Alright, appreciate it.
Alright, I got it pinned up here on the bow side. If y'all want to start breaking it down to get out, we'll put soft lines between you and the Kashada and break you off the inside.
Roger on that.
First day on the job. For me, yeah, it seems like it. It sure would look like it. I can't even line up my cables. Red Wolves send the sunshine straight north to Arkansas. Well, we had the sun, and look at it now. It was beautiful. It was freaking beautiful just a minute ago. Now there's clouds everywhere. It wasn't supposed to rain today. Sissy McSus face, do you have any sort of range extender antenna? For my Starlink, I don't. Time to run errands, friends. Have a great rest of your day. Have fun. Don't make good decisions. You have a good day, Rasky. Get them errands knocked out. We need a hand, all these ready to go out today. And welcome in, Red Wolves 1. We're fixing to get these two barges out. Pull two of them out. Well, pull four out. Let two leave and push the other two back in. This guy here wants some fuel. I could probably bring the fuel barge out here to him. Try to get your fuel, man, on these barges. Like you said, you need some, so I'm just trying to figure out. Now I could bring the, now that these two are leaving on the inside of you, I could probably bring the flat out here and get it on the outside, just still have you push it, you know.
Yeah, that's fine.
How much you need on each barge, you know, right offhand?
No, not too much. It's probably a couple of thousand on each barge.
Yeah, all right. I mean, yeah, we here to give you all the fuel. We can, you know, if we can get it to you, we can't turn you down.
All right, y'all on the head.
No problem.
So.
That's my phone line. Let me know when you want me to drop it.
All right, we'll get back with you then.
Okay.
You'd be ready to take it anytime?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, sounds good.
Okay.
I gotta just figure out what we're gonna do with that fuel, man. I thought you were on sale. Well, let me see. Hold on. Am I on Starlink? Yeah, I'm on Starlink. I switched it over the last stream, and for the most part, it's okay. It's just if I start moving around a little bit, it'll kind of lose signal, but then come right back. Okay, let me put y'all on this side. Because he's gonna push out over here. We got a ship passing. Lucky day. We got a ship. That's a lucky day. Let's see how fast that ship's going. He is.
Miss Wayne, we're waiting for this ship to go by, or are we gonna continue turning it loose?
Oh, you continue turning it loose. Yeah. Yeah. We'll just keep on. I'll keep pushing it in.
by the time he gets, we get ready, he'll be past us.
All right.
Do they still have soft lines? Y'all still have the soft lines between the Kashada and the Kalen?
Soft lines between the gray and black lines.
Okay, roger that.
Hey, let me go over here and double check. No, that ain't lying.
I sure like having two guys on deck this week. That's nice. Oh, excuse me. Right now. 8:50. 8:50 sounds good to me. Alright, I got you out at 8:50 if that's good.
Yeah, 8:50 sounds good. Appreciate you.
Hey, he's just right now learning what these wet cotton lines are about.
We just pulled out a while ago is coming back because there's an issue at the dock, and he's like, he ain't putting up with no bullshit today, so he's coming back for a little bit. Here, these two barges and boats probably going to need some fuel, so we may go get the flat and bring it here in a little bit.
Wind's too bad.
Wind ain't bad on a load, god dang it.
It is. Is that lightning?
That was yesterday.
It was too fast, too fast. Robert, get out of the way. Get out of the way, Robert.
It was that? I got this in. I got it. I've only done this about 5 times. I got it.
Okay, okay.
Alright, we're gonna need to come ahead about 10 to 15 feet already. For 125 wide on the bow.
Bro, these captains, man, I tell you what, they act like I don't know what I'm doing. These dudes act like I don't even know what the hell I'm doing. It's kind of insulting.
Hell, Cap, we already cut loose. Why don't we just drag these in there to the fuel plant and tell them to fuel them up? Just saying. 100 wide and stern.
looking at were barely crawling out. He acted like I was freaking to slam his barge over there, man. I swear to God.
Hold on a minute and get he not tell us he left? Douglas Murphy. No, he was not in our fleet. No. Where was he at? I don't know where he was, but he wasn't in our fleet. Wait a minute. No. No, he was not. Did you sleep well, Slim Pickin? You slept in. When my alarm clock goes off in the morning, I sure wish I could sleep in. I do not like waking up at 5 in the morning.
We're locked in. All fast, all bad.
Okay, Roger, on that. All right, we're going to help this boat land here in a minute. It's coming with an empty over there. We're just helping land. I'm going to put a line in case the wind got it.
Roger, Roger.
Roger, Roger. Well, the title of the stream says we have sunshine. When I started the stream, we did have sunshine. And now we don't. So, yeah. Don't you love when people how to tell you how to do your job? Next time, tell them you stayed at a Holiday Inn Express. I'm not a captain, but I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night. Oh, Red Mozzie. Thank you, Red Mozzie, for that raid. I'm going to check you out this morning, Red Mozzie. I was in your stream for a little bit this morning. It was early, though. You were sitting talking to some people, but I don't know where you were at. Thank you for that raid, Red Mozzie. Who else came in with Red Mozzie? Brandy, 7702, good morning. James is home. He'll be here next week. NGL, is it NGL SWT? Hello, welcome in. Yeah, when they have me busy doing moving barges, I kind of miss some chat. But thank you so much, sir, for coming in. He said to send his love as he had to travel home. Yeah, I saw he was out and about. I didn't see you in this morning, Brandy, because it was early. It was before daylight he was on. And I don't think I saw you in modding for him. I think you're a mod there. But I didn't see you were in at the time. About you, Scott Camp?
On the side, buddy.
Hey, how you want to flip it when you get here?
Why don't I let you come up on the starboard side?
Yeah.
And I'll top around you that way.
Okay, yeah, I can already be on this side getting the line while you're doing your thing. Yeah, that'll work. And then I can control that side, the other bow.
Yes, sir.
You say you're gonna top the your bow towards the fleet?
Yes, sir. I'll top it towards the fleet.
Okay, Roger that. When you start making the turn, now I'll ease up to you.
All right.
Okay, Roger that. Hello, Janjir, my dear. How are you? Good morning. Yes, I was sleeping. He started at 5 a.m. your time, which was 4 my time. Yeah, because when I got up, I came up here and I looked to see who was on, and I saw he was on. Yup. Thank you for that raid, though. Mikey. Hello, Mikey. Good morning. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 11 cavils on this barge. That is freaking awesome, having 11 cavils that you can tie off to. Jokes. Let me know if you need me to stop.
to line it up where you want it. Okay, I'm back. My hands just love coming up here and talk to me. They just love it. Alright, I lightly got you pinned up here.
Alright, thank you, sir.
My hands talk to me sometimes also with you, pervert. Janjir, what the hell? Jesus. What? You said it. How long can he stay in that corner? Rope Slinger was my nickname in high school. Oh, okay, I misunderstood. I'm sorry, Janjir, I misunderstood.
All touched up.
Alrighty, so I need to decide whether I'm gonna have them that barge bring his that boat bring his barges to the fuel dock, or if I'm gonna bring the fuel flat out here. It's way easier for him to bring it to us. To be honest. All right, so I'm gonna log this guy back in, even though he just left. 915-015-3023. I might have slept good because I had a late night talk with Peanut Butter Man on Discord. He's pretty nice to talk to. He was having some sugar issues, low blood sugar or something, last night. So hopefully he got that taken care of. Any ships that are due to come in or out there in the Carbide Canal in the next few hours?
Let me look at my pilot sheet. Let's see.
he's boarding at 10:30 from out there?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I was going to see about fueling up a couple of barges over there on 42. And I don't know what they think about me being there. We've had one pass before with no problem, but I don't want to cause an issue with them pilots, you know?
Yeah, it just depends on who it is, but, you know, we can't take that chance, you know?
Yeah. All right, then. All right. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he said he fell asleep, then he got back up and he hit me up on Discord. We talked and then we ended up streaming. Oh, he ended up streaming. I got you. I don't know. He was full of shit after that. Ella, he was on the road. You didn't see it, Captain. If not, you missed it. Yeah, because I was probably in bed. If it was after mid... But I didn't look at much Twitch before midnight either. I got off early. And I relisted some items on eBay.
Thank you. I do appreciate it.
All right, what you got there, Scott Camp? I was on the phone.
Okay. Do you need to log an account in, or how you
want
to do that?
Yeah, since I put you in a different position, I did do the log in and log out. Not then Buffalo will just take care of how they want to do it. They may not even call you out, but being you came right back. I did put you back showing at 9:15, so like I said, I don't know, they'll probably handle it on that end.
Roger, thank you.
Blacktop was free. This one's gonna cost you a cake.
I hear you.
A cake? Ew, lordy.
Yeah, just make it to it. Send a bill to the company.
Roger, on that. Sack of crawfish, we'll call it even.
About eight. That's how we
bill it.
We need to make it 2 sacks of crawfish.
That,
Oh, it's up to like
$300
a sack now.
Yeah, yeah. You get one and I get one.
Better make it 4. 1 ain't enough for us.
Right.
Crawfish is expensive right now. There's a shortage.
Yeah, I got you, buddy. I got you.
There's a...
What time did you call down here?
Had it out at 8:20. I ain't even gonna call that, man. Not what, even an hour. So I'll go ahead and take them off. I'll take them off of there and just show you move positions. So yeah, that'll work.
No, I appreciate it. All phone, all aboard, no problem. And if we do leave to go back up there. I'll just call you
at
an out time.
Okay, roger that.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, my back. All right, so I need to redo this log sheet because mud bug shortage, what's going on? With the drought last year that we had, there's just no crawfish right now. It's real low quantities, so it's like $15 a pound or something right now, I heard. $15 a pound for crawfish, it's like outrageous. Mud bug shortage. Now, maybe later in the year, like the place we usually go eat at, they have them by now. He won't get them till March. He said the earliest he sees them getting them is March. He was saying it's $350 a sack right now if you want a sack of crawfish. It's rare. They're rare. Yeah, let me fix this, man. God dang it. Okay. I like crawfish, but I don't like $3.50 crawfish. I mean, $15 a pound crawfish. I don't like that. I don't like them that much. think I got this fixed. I think we're good. What time was that? That was at 8:50. Like this, but we're probably gonna go get that fuel flat and bring it out here. I mean, that's part of our job, you know. Yeah, go ahead. Alright, I just departed here, heading that way anyway, so coming your way. Oh, let me call that Don Carlton and see if he feels like leaving too. Cherokee's all the way to the inside. He will get over it.
Move it over for you also.
He will. He absolutely will. That's quite expensive for crawfish. Good morning, Susie Q. Yeah, it is quite expensive. I ain't eating them. I'll go catch my own crawfish. I'm gonna find a ditch and get my own. Only pelicans, no seagull poop today. Let's call this Don Carlton, see if he feels like leaving.
Call the clerk, gonna be coming out of Galveston, gonna be running the flat. Wake up to your manager, just last four around there, and checking that line. What part you love about the bar?
Hey, it's Miss Moni, man. Y'all still, y'all know if y'all still leaving today or y'all still gonna hold up?
We're gonna hold up for the weather, you know, and don't have any fixed space in Houston.
Okay, alright, because I'm fixing to get that Cherokee out from the inside of you there, so I'm coming there to get him out and push everything over.
Alright, you need me to help you or you got it?
Well, I mean, if you had a hand maybe available, I can get a hand off them other boats or see if they'll help out too or whatever, but yeah, just to get us, because I have to push all, there'll be 2, 4 to 6 barges there. I got to push all 6 of them over and then I'll re-tie them up again to the dock and to the pile and the pier. So if you had a guy that could walk over there and give us a hand, would be appreciated. Maybe I don't need you with the boat, I can use one of them other boats.
Oh okay.
Yeah,
what town are you be working?
We'll be on 76.
All right, I'll send a man out there, Derek.
All right. Okay. All right. All right. Appreciate it, man.
Yeah. Thank you.
Goodbye. That's the scared captain right there. That's the one that we call the scared one. It's kind of rough out there. We're gonna wait for the weather to calm down. All right, let's call a boat here and see who we're gonna get. Oh, I think we might get some more sunshine. What boat I gotta call? I gotta call the Miss Carter W. Let's see if the Miss Carter W can give me a hand. Yes. Get that Cherokee out on the pier with it's too stretched out, and I gotta push everything over to the corner. I just need you to be able to shove it forward for me when I get it pushed over.
That's no problem.
Alrighty, yeah. I'll be nice to these captains out here. I gotta be nice to them because I may have to ask them for a favor. And they can say, man, you was kind of a dick to me yesterday. I don't know if I want to help you. You know, if you're gonna be a dick to me, I might not want to help you out. So the moral of this story is don't be a dick. That's the moral. I'm full of wisdom. Full of wisdom. He said there's no fleet space in Houston. Man, no place to bring barges into Houston? That's crazy. That is something. Because there's tons of fleets in Houston. Let me see what barges he's got. Who is that boat for? That's for the, that's FMT, that's Florida Marine, so. They use their own fleet. They have their own fleet up there. Plus, they can use Boone's fleet, or they can use Cheryl K's old fleet. And there's no room. If there's no room with them fleets, they got a lot of barges up there. Oh, let me call the Lauren Elizabeth because he was talking about leaving today too. Let me see what his plan is. He's in that bunch of boats there we're about to move. He's sleeping.
Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not available. At the tone.
Of course he ain't. Tough bid. Do you think you have transported drugs while you've been doing this for a career? Okay, so knowingly? No. Knowingly? Absolutely not. unknowingly, there has been not transporting this industry. I don't know if it's like any other industries, but this industry is, it happens. You have people that bring their own little secret stash, and they try to hide it, but sometimes they get caught, and then they have to hit the road. More than you think. That's why we got to take random drug tests. But then there's some of them that want to use that fake, it's like a fake urine, and they try to beat the system, try to ways to get around it. It's crazy. Hello, Do Think. I'm back. Yeah, if somebody walks up here and wants to talk to me, I put it on mute. You never know what they're gonna say. They might want to say something personal, you know. And it, so yeah, I just, and when I hear them come up the stairs, if y'all hear it mute all of a sudden, it's because someone's coming up the stairs and I hit the button. So that wasn't intentional or not. Yes. About you, Cherokee. Alright, we're about to get up to you there. I got that Carter, Miss Carter W is going to crank up and help us push it over after you back out. Told me what he asked me, tell me what he's making for lunch, if that was okay. He ain't got to check with me. I'll eat anything they cook, as long as it's keto friendly. He's cooking catfish and shrimp today, is on the menu. Fried catfish and boiled shrimp. Do you know anyone in Texas that's good at painting or graffiti art? Oh, I don't think I do, tell you the truth. Don't believe so. So then that means tomorrow is going to be steak day. Because one of the two weekend days we have steaks. This week has passed pretty quick. So you need some streamers looking for someone to do some art. I do not know of anyone. No. Ship that was here left out. That's one of the two ships that left this morning. I think it was that second one. That second black one was right here, and now he's gone. Well, that's good, because he was right next to our fleet, so that's good that he left. How bad is the weather supposed to be today over there? I think it's only supposed to be windy. As far as rain, I think the rain was done. But the clouds moved in. It was sunshining this morning. It was beautiful. And then all of a sudden, all these clouds showed up here. But no rain yet. But these boats are talking about wind. So, ooh, who that boat's for? Ooh, hey, hold up. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, Mr. Howell.
This is.
Hey, good afternoon, sir. My name's Ed. I work out here with Bass Credit. We're contacting homeowners here on Ralph Sweeney. I was just wondering if you guys still had the original bathroom working with your home.
We're pretty good with our bathroom. I just got a shower put in there about a year ago or 2 years, so I'm good. I do.
Okay, only reason I ask is we do the heavy duty insulated replacement windows, more energy efficient than the standard builder grade. But if you folks ever decided to replace them someday, how many do you think you might need just by taking a quick look around?
I don't know, but I think right now I gotta get my house level, man, right now, so I can't afford no windows.
Oh, I gotcha. Well, you take care of yourself and have a great one, okay?
I appreciate the call, though. God dang it. The hell, man. I shouldn't answer that call. Shouldn't answer that one. How about your Cherokee? You have them hang that shackle if they already started taking that wire off. If they can hang it on that, there's a chain there. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I guess you can put outside 0945. We're good. Give it a shot.
Okay, yeah, I just tried to call and see if y'all wanted to leave because I'm fixing to push all this over.
Right on that, yeah.
Okay, Roger, how about your Cherokee? You want to let them get out first here then? You want to let them back out and go and then we get you out or what?
Yeah, we can. That'd make it a little easier on everybody. Yeah, we'll let him get out first. That's fine.
Okay, Roger that. I knew that dude was going to leave. Okay, so these two boats, these two barges I'm on right here, strung out, are fixing to leave. He's going to go ahead and back out. Then I'll get on the one on the inside of that. We'll put a headline so the one on the pier can back out.
All right, so take your line off and then take shoreline
off,
right?
Yeah, we'll let this one get out. I'll just pin it in right now while he's undoing everything. It looks like they're doing it now, actually, getting ready. So, yeah, we'll go ahead and get this guy. He's going to back out, and then we'll get a line on the inside. I told you.
Going to the starboard side of us is leaving. He's backing out first. Then the one on the port side is gonna back out after.
Man, I told y'all it's a mass exodus out of here. That guy doesn't sound awake. I know, huh? He's fixing to leave though. He better wake up. Damn, they taking everything off. Good Lord. It's a mad exodus out here. Would you like to buy some windows? I mean, one day, but seriously, I do have to have my house level. So I can't afford windows. I would need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 windows. Of different sizes, of course. Actually, probably more, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of my windows are double windows. I should have asked him, do you level houses? There must be a sale of gray paint. Okay, Roger that. All right, Miss Lauren Elizabeth, I'm off of you if you want to start backing out.
All right, brother.
As a matter of fact, I need to call that guy this week and see. I think I'll be ready to do it. Probably February or March, I'll do the house level. Because he's, man, y'all, I don't know if I told y'all what he's going to have to do. He's going to have to pull our carpet up. We're going to have to move all kind of crap out the way, pull the carpet back. He's going to have to bust through the cement inside the house to get underneath the slab in 9 places and jack up the center of the freaking house. It's not going to be pretty at all. Looking forward to it.
Appreciate everything that happens, Monday. We'll see y'all next time.
Hey, Roger, what you said that time was? At 9 something?
I thought it was 9:45. Is that all right with you?
Yep, I'll put it down.
All right.
Then they got to fill the holes up, and then I got to get somebody to come lay my carpet down again, because I don't know how to do that. I ain't a carpet guy. I drive a boat. Okay, FMT 3208 and FMT 3128 at 0945 Miss Lauren Elizabeth. You know, all these boats did tell me they were going to leave after, and when the wind calmed down. I mean, the fog got out. They did tell me that. Why can't they go through the crawl space to jack it up? We don't have a crawl space. We are on a full cement slab. The problem is, it's in the middle of the house that the walls got the crack in it. It's not that bad yet, but the drought we had last year with no rain.
Cherokee, Lauren Elizabeth.
just freaking made the dirt settle, man. All the dirt settled. Ooh, y'all want to see something? It looks like the front of this boat, the front of this barge, look at the dent. You see how this one right here looks? This skag, that's called a skag. Look at that skag. That one got a dent. It's denting in. It hit something hard. If I don't watch what I'm doing, I'm fixing to hit pretty hard myself. Still on the boat here? Is y'all on the barge?
We're both on the barge. We're over here, Cassie.
Okay, yeah, I'll need a headline here before they back out.
Roger, I'm on the way.
Okay, let me put y'all here. Here's a good spot. So this guy we just backed out, this dude's backing out next with the red barges. Yeah, they had a hot sale on some gray paint. They had a hot sale, Brindy. A hot sale. Somebody lost their brakes on that skag. Maybe that's why he's scared. Well, the scared captain is over here. He's on the dock. He ain't ready to leave yet. Alright, let me mark this Cherokee. That's getting out of here. China cabin has to be moved, and that thing is heavy as hell, and might have to move like a couple of the love seat, and the part of the TV entertainment center has got to be moved, and probably the dresser in our room. I need the guy to come down there when I'm home so he can show me exactly where he has to go into the cement and poke the holes. And then after that, like I said, I'm gonna have to hire somebody to come lay the carpet down again. To stretch it, because you gotta stretch it, you gotta get it stretched back out real nice and tight, and all that good stuff. The only thing I'm hoping is that they don't have to go into our kitchen floor, our dining room floor, because that's tile. And that tile.
I got a blanket here.
Hey, what's that?
It's called I Got a Malcolm in Here, the Homeless in Here.
Okay, Roger. So that tile was put in probably 8-9 years ago, and I don't know if I can find that pattern again. That pattern's probably gone. So if they have to break the tile to go into the cement there, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't want to replace a whole kitchen floor, man. I've made pancakes for breakfast. Any takers? Are they keto pancakes?
They have pork roll in them. There you go. Big time, big boy knows what's up. Put a little pork roll in them. Sadly, no. No keto cat, sorry. Ginger will take them. We had 10 barges in here this morning. Now we're going to be down to 4. It should have been down to 2, but that one dude don't want to leave yet. He better not say, once we get this thing pushed over and tied up, he better not say he's ready to leave. All right, Cap, yeah, I think we're going to leave out now. I'll be like, bro, we just had your barges untied. We just had them untied, ready to go. Yeah, because, I mean, I bought it at, we got that tile at, we bought it at, it was either Homes or Lowe Depot, Homes or Lowe Depot, what the hell, Lowe's or Home Depot, Lowe's, oh, Home Depot. I think I'm ready for a nap. Loans are Home Depot. You did some research for years and found them? Square tiles in our house. Homes Build Depot too. I need to go to the Home Depot. I think he's waiting for that other boat to back out all the way and leave. Once that one that just backed out gets flipped around and takes off, then that red barge is going to leave.
know, Brandy, I think in our garage, I may have three or four of those extra tiles from when we bought them. And maybe if I bring those in and they see that we can match it up, we might be able to match that up. And if they have to, I'm just going to hope that they don't have to do it. But in case, well, I could take a broken piece. If they have to, I'll just take a broken piece in there and say, do you have this? Cactus Jack says, great, now I want pancakes.
I'll be safe.
Now, if I go to IHOP, I do get the pancakes, keto or not. I have to have them. I get the Colorado omelet and the pancakes. I love the Colorado, and I have him add spinach to it. So it's all the meats I like, plus it has spinach in it. All right, that red barge is slowly backing out right now. And then, what is that? Code 45. Oil pressure. What? Oh, oil pressure ain't low. What the hell's going on with that? It's a sensor, I bet. Let me see.
bro.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I'm showing a low oil pressure here on the port engine. When we get this secure, man, I'll see about you checking that out. Miss Carter W., if you want to wait till he clears your stern there a little bit, you can take him out of gear and I'll just ease it over. Yeah, but it's good now. It's showing 20 pounds of pressure in clutch and the other one's 23. So, it could be a sensor. We do have sensors that act up every once in a while, but you can't take that for granted. They have to check it. Make sure the oil level's good. Like right now, it's fine. Because I put it in gear. When I was just sitting there at idle, I heard it go off.
Touch up. 6 feet. Touch up. 6 feet. Touch up. 6 inches. Touch up. 55.
Who was it that used to talk about snow monkeys in here? I don't remember who that was. First they was talking about looking for gators. Always wanted to see the gators.
Did you hear about 6 inches? 6 inches, something right on the side.
All right, I got your pin.
Okay, hang a little bit harder there. Drop again.
Yeah, I'm hooked up. It'll come back. It just bounced off. It'll come back, I think. Yeah, what is it for?
Oh, the harbor tub?
Yes, sir.
Okay, does he can get in on the, yeah, he can get over here in front of that old offshore tub. That dock's clear over here, right across from the gate. He can get on this side here instead of by the water connection. There's a harbor, like a harbor tug, not a harbor tug, an offshore tug that's tied up here where the roll-off dock is.
Okay.
It's like right between 41 and 42, he can get up there on the dock.
Between 41 and 42.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they come up here before, so yeah, there's no boats there, and he can get there.
I'll relay the message. Thank you.
All right, yeah, if they have to give me a call, they can call his number.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
Right. You'll need that dog out.
See it, maybe there's some kind of water leak going on right there. It looks like a water leak to me. Let me go take a look at that. I want to go see what that is. That looks a little unusual to me.
Tears. Nope. He says no volunteers to taste the water.
But let Mikey try it.
Coming out of the bay.
What's that?
I don't think that's from the fire boat because all the fire piping is painted red.
Let Mikey try it. He'll try anything.
Oh, I could be wrong. It's been known to happen once before.
Once? He'd been wrong. How they say that? I thought I was wrong once. I'm not always right. I thought I was wrong once. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Man, that dude's got some flags I don't have on that boat. His company flags. I think I asked him about it, though. Port of Wilmington, Delaware? That boat is from what? Oh, that's strategic. Oh, that's Strategic Marine. Okay. Yeah. I'm supposed to call their office about getting a flag from them. Strategic. We're gonna have to go freaking pump this barge out there. We're gonna have to bring it out. I got to. I know the tankman ain't gonna like it, but I got to. That's part of our job, man. Shut that engine down and check the oil in it. Hey, Bo, I'm gonna get you to shut that port engine down. I'll leave the starboard one running. Shut it down and let it settle and check and see if it looks good.
All right, I was gonna shut them both down. Just check them both out. That's okay.
Yeah, because after that, I called the harbor master and they got two ships that's gonna be passing here at noon. So, one at 10:30, one afternoon, so I was going to probably bring this barge out. All right, so he's going to check the engines. You can check them both. Check them both. Check both engines. Both of these engines. I should say, yeah, check both of
He said, both of, yeah, both of these nuts. Hello, GT940. Oh Lordy. They had a pretty good stream this morning, I think. Once he checks the engines, we'll crank them back up and we'll grab this barge and start heading out there to the fleet with it. Oh, we got some pigeons. My son used to call them pigeons when he was a kid. Hey, look at the pigeons. Here, let me zoom in on the pigeons. There, a rail full of pigeons. Yeah, he called them pigeons. They live, I'm gonna tell you, show you where they live at. They live underneath that awning there where that orange crane thing is, where in that building, they live in the rafters up under there. Cause I used to park my truck in there, you can back your truck in there, and they would poop all over my truck. So that's where they live. So they come out here to get sun. And chill out here, I guess. That's their recreation areas right here. That's a lot of water coming out of that over there. Yeah, it is. You know, I can call the harbor master and ask him about it. Let me call him. I don't know if that's their department, but let me call them and find out.
Scott.
Hey man, it's the Miss Moni at Buffalo Fleet.
Uh-huh.
Hey, over there at Dock 41, that finger pier that goes out there when the ships tie up, there's like a pumping station. There's a lot of water coming out from underneath it. I just didn't know if that's fresh water, if that's water they suck up from the harbor here.
It's coming out from underneath the firehouse?
Yeah, it's like a firehouse station. I guess that's what it is. Is that what it is?
Man, I'm not sure. I'll follow there and find out.
Yeah, it's like halfway, almost halfway down the pier behind the ship, and it's a white building. But they have like a red pipe that goes into it, like maybe that is their fire pumping system to put out a fire. But it's a lot of water coming from underneath it, and I didn't know if like that was fresh water they use out of the harbor here or not.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, I'll give them a call.
All right, man, appreciate it.
All right.
That might be a big old water leak. I'm off to do Sunday errands. Be safe and have fun. What's on the Sunday errand list? Some shopping? Play in the poops. Take care of Brendy. Have a good day. Some grocery shopping. Some, maybe catch a movie. Have a dinner. Is that Audrey on the side? Let me see if I got his phone number. You don't have to get on that tug. How about you, Audrey?
Audrey.
Hey, you can get on the bulkhead there if you want, in front of that tug. If you want to, you know, tie up there to get right on the boat. That's all pretty good water there.
Okay, Roger that. Yeah, I wasn't seeing anything I could make my lines off to.
Oh.
Are those stanchions pretty solid on that platform?
Not real solid. Nah, if you, like I said, if you do want to use that tug, you're more than welcome. I mean, we put the boats push up to it all the time, so you can use that if you want, or try to get anywhere along that bulkhead that you can't find somewhere to tie. But they just got clips holding the bottom.
Okay, Roger that. Yeah, we'll grab a line on this boat. I appreciate it.
Good deal. That's a good deal.
Hey, that guy. Hey, Roger, on the way.
You know when you start coming to head on that pickup? Stop it, pick over.
A pickup?
Yeah, that you waiting on a boat to come in? Or a bottle?
Yeah, Roger, waiting on the entrance.
Let me call that boat, see if he feels good, comfortable coming over here with his barge. I'm gonna just, let me just ask him. Damn it, shit. What was his name again? The, Cashada. The Cashada. Let me call him and ask him.
That's Scott Roberts on that ship.
Hey, yeah, it's Miss Moni. How would you feel afternoon sometime if you brought your barges up here and we tied them up to the flat and we'll help you get it on and then get you back in the fleet over there to get your fuel? Okay. Yeah, yeah, because they got ships passing here, but instead of me putting all this weight on that empty tier, we can get you up here and do the job right here, and then we'll bring you back over there and help you get in the fleet. You know, we'll assist you either, you know, both times. Okay, all right then. Yeah, bye. Oh, well, he said, we'll see what the pilot says. And if not, they'll just do the boat. I really don't feel good tying up this barge on an empty fleet. Putting a load on an empty fleet is you asking for trouble. It's too much weight. Because we tie them up different. You tie up empties different than you tie up loads. Got it. Thanks. That helps me out, so I'm not looking for the missing number. What does that mean? Buffalo Fleet.
Hey, Brian, the call is to the Buffalo Marine CP.
What's that?
I'm trying to get into the gate.
Oh. Oh, you over there at the gate?
Yes.
Yeah, it's the code's 42 pound.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Permission to come up, Rob?
Yeah, come on, man.
Yeah, 42 pounds. Hey, Bo.
Yeah.
There, Woody Richardson's coming around the dike, so we're going to go pin him in so he can get on the other side of his toe.
Okay.
All right.
Going
to
fire you up now.
Alrighty. Alright, I'm back. Engine's good. Hey, Dookie. Hello, Dookie. You the same old, they'll get my back. Wait. Yeah, the same old, they'll get my back isn't 20 anymore type thing, but just normal stuff at 40 apparently. Hello, Dookie Creek. So he checked the engine. The engine oil's fine. I think it's just because I was sitting at idle. And it dipped down a little bit lower than, because it didn't, but yeah, engine's good, oil's good. Going back out to the other fleet. Hey Cap, you know what else I missed? I missed doing pretty good. Is that where all the cool kids are? Who's on the other side? We have Cactus Jack, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Do not adjust your value.
You're all gone.
Dave McNamara. Let me see where the Dave McNamara's at now. He wanted a spot. David McNamara. He's still up in Houston. Let me call him and see if he wanted a spot still. Still needed a spot at the fleet?
We are, but we just heard from the fleet with the weather and all. I mean, from the splitting dock, they're not probably going to be ready until Monday.
Oh, so okay. All right.
Monday sometime.
All right. Well, get back with us then. You know, they come in and out all day around here, and the weather started blowing a little bit. So. But all right. Well, I'll keep you on there. You know, we'll just... I'll let the other cap know that at least Monday, but you know, we'll keep you on there and see what happens.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, once we get the clearance to
Can you send us in, please?
All right then.
I'll definitely let you guys know once we get a rough idea when we're gonna be taking up beforehand.
All right, sounds good.
Appreciate it,
Dan. Okay, bye. Are you taking the fuel barge with you? No, I'm not going to take it.
Okay, yeah.
No.
Are you fighting any shots at crosswind or is it right off your back?
Riley Brown's going to be dropping line up here at Valero Dock number 56.
If anything, we'll do it this afternoon. If he wants fuel on his barges, I'll do it this afternoon.
Meet this guy and get her straightened out.
We'll get him. I'll get him his fuel, even if it's after he loads. When he finishes loading, we'll get him up here. We can get him up here, time up, get his fuel to him. His boat, he can come get his fuel on the boat at any time. He can come up here and get it any time. It's just to bring that fuel flat out there where he's tied up or whatever.
It's quiet in here today. Yeah, it's been, people just been kind of lurking, hanging out. We've been moving some barges. I just got 4 out a while ago. 2 sets left out of here. And then, we've been moving some stuff. How long have I been on? Almost 3 hours. It's been pretty good stream. 3 hours and been kind of busy. They got some windsurfers up there. Let's see if y'all can see him with the zoom in. Yeah, see him? 3 of them. It's the weekend and they playing. Yeah, go ahead. Hey, Roger, I'm heading out that way and get you on that tier. Get Roger that. Hot also. Dang, the Colorado River at Matagorda is going out at 3.2 miles an hour. The current is 3.2. That's freaking strong. It don't affect us because we don't work over there, but still. That's a strong current. Sanjak is 3.2. That must have been a lot of rain. Get out of that freaking email, that text message. I need to opt out of that text message. To leave out, it looks like. Sound like he's ready to leave. He's like, what you got on the wind gauge?
Security call. William Fowler on the way. Outbound. Galveston.
Yeah, I'll be away from chat for just a minute while I catch up this What's missing? Oh, yeah, okay, while I catch this up real quick. The web barn just left. One, two, three. Okay, that's right. I was confused for a second. It didn't look right. We good.
You over here today on it?
Okay, I'm back now. I'm back. How you doing, Skyline? How you doing, Skyline?
Mark.
Hi, buddy. Yeah, it's a little quiet today. Dookie, it was so beautiful this morning. It was sunshining and bright. And about an hour into the stream, clouds rolled in. No rain, though, just cloudy. That is a lot of traffic.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
A lot of traffic today. Buffalo Fleet?
Hey, Bud James on the garden here.
Hey, man.
Are you going to have anywhere out there that out of here where I can string out 900 foot?
Oh, wow. 900? Man. I could do six, but I can't. I don't think I could do nine. We've never done nine before.
Okay. All right. I'll figure out something else. I have to get that Aiden Phillips. I have to do it out here on the bank or something. Get that Aiden Phillips to bring me my other barge.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Which one's yours?
The 3008.
Okay. Oh, yeah. And his is on top of yours, too. Dang it. Yeah, we'll have to figure something out then. I'd have to get a boat to help because that other boat took off and I'll have another Genesis boat here to move his over. I'll get yours out. And you can't leave your barges either because you're on the dock over there.
Nope.
God dang.
Do you have room on that, where you're at over there now? For me to string these two out and then go get that other one?
Let me see, man, because I got six barges on that tier now. It's all Genesis barges, six Genesis barges there now. And I've got four on the heater tier. So, I mean, if it's just for you to string out and hang out, you know, we could probably do it, you know, put you string them out on that tier and just have them pinned in case the ship passes, because that's a lot of weight, you know. Yeah, we could. Oh, yeah, yes, yeah, we can. Yes, we can do that.
Bring them two in here, bring them two in there, string them out.
Yes, and string it right behind it.
Get another one.
And string right behind it and put 900 foot right there. There you go. As long as you ain't running heaters, yeah, we can do it right there.
We ain't got no heaters.
Yeah, that's probably the safest place to do it. Yep, we'll string your two out, then bring your other one in and put it behind it how you want it, and you can pull all three out, 900 foot.
All right, man.
All right, that'll work.
All right, appreciate you,
buddy. Okay, bye. Damn, I didn't even think about that. That'll work perfect. String out his 900 foot over there at Dock 42. Bam, he's good to go. That sounds like a wiener. All the ham radio guys get together and activate from park, got to cabin. Wait, from a park, got to cabins. Well, that can only be one or two people. Cabins. Let's see, all the ham radio guys getting together to activate from a park got two cabins. Okay, I'm going to put this dude on the same tier as the Lauren Elizabeth. There you go. Miss Moni Woody Richardson.
Hey, Woody, come on back.
Yeah, okay, so I can pin you in on the same tier as the Brianna Elizabeth, because he's sticking out further, and then you can break off and get on the other side. I'll pin you in there while you're doing all that and keep it nice and tight.
Okay, okay. All right, you got anything else going on?
No, I'm heading out that way to get you in there.
Okay, I'm just curious. Under his pilot, how he is. Just
want
to say if anything else going on
or
not. Coach is sitting up there at 33.
Oh, to help you in 33, you mean?
Yeah, just make sure, you know. If it's me, I wouldn't worry about that nose pilot there. So, just in case, you know, would be pushing into a right now and then get over that way. I think I have no problem getting up in there, but just want to make sure. If you got things you got to do, I understand.
I know. Right now, we're good. There's nothing really happening.
Okay, all right. Well, we appreciate it very much. You help me get situated and all that good stuff. Thank you,
Stan.
You need a fleet time or whatever?
Nah, just for you to make on the other end there. I ain't gonna put you in.
Okay, all right. Would you prefer me to go ahead and flip around first? Or what? And then do it? Or just go ahead and lay first and then come out?
Yeah, you can. It's easy to just drive in like you are, man, and we'll get you pinned in and you can, you know, make up on the other end and flip around and leave.
Okie dokie, sir. Later,
William. Okie dokie.
Hey, Robin.
Okie dokie. Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, man. I copied the end of that conversation there. We're going to be taking off at R2. We're going to be in the way.
You leaving right now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I tell you what. If you want to leave now, then I'll just put him on tier 2, and that'll be sticking up further. So, yeah, if y'all on time right now and you can get out in about the next 5 minutes, you can go ahead and leave.
All right, yeah, my guy's heading out now, turn loose.
Hey, Roger, that. Yeah, Woody Richardson, just kind of just drag your feet just a little bit. We'll get that Brianna out and then you'll have a little bit more room.
I got her down to clutch.
Well, God damn it.
Woody Richardson.
Hey, buddy, you come to 33 with some green.
We'll be coming to 33 with empties.
We'll give you a shout. We're getting ready to come out of here. I'm 34.
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
It's not like a busy, busy morning.
Robert, you wanna call it out at 11?
Yeah, Roger that, man. Got you at 11.
I sure appreciate you.
All right, yeah, we'll let you get out first, and since he's still 5-10 minutes away there. He's slowing down, so that'll work. 11 o'clock. So he's leaving too. That is the Brianna Elizabeth.
Cherokee, you
on this line? Elizabeth.
I got it cut back.
Get a ship across
intersection and
I'm
driving on across the bottom.
203
inbound.
291 28 11 o'clock. Yeah, Robert, if we would have stopped long enough, I'd have come visit you for a minute. That boat in front of us is leaving with two red barges.
They're waiting on the wind, but I guess the bus girl's gonna get you. Bus girl's not the 30 earlier, but we're good now.
Yeah, Roger that. Yeah, they got some boats moving around, and so it may not be too bad. Ain't nothing for a stepper like you to go. Come on, you can do it, Roberto. Love it when a plan comes together. Yeah, basically we rented two cabins at the state park and going to talk on radios. It's 1 p.m. today till 1 p.m. tomorrow. Oh, I got you. How far is it from where you live? Like, it's close to you? Yeah, Woody Richardson. So I'm going to put you next to the Cachado over there, that number two tier. We'll put you in there just like you are, and then... You'll have room to get on that other end. Nothing in your way.
Okie dokie. Wait on. If you need a ladder, just go pin them.
Yeah, I'm just going to pin them in. They can put some soft lines in. We won't be wiring them in or anything. Oh, I don't know. I see what you're saying now. You need a line on? You want me to get a line on you, Woody Richardson, to help land you or what?
Oh, we should be okay.
Okay, yeah. I'll just get in, shadow you in there, and let you land it. Then once you touch, I'll pin it.
Okay.
No line.
Robert, you take my last wire off now.
Okay, Roger that. All right, let's go enter this in the computer now. So this morning we got out of here. On my watch, we got out eight barges left out of here this morning on my watch. Wait, hold on. On my watch, ten barges total left out of here. 11 barges total. This is the Brianna Elizabeth. See what Dookie said about that. Dookie said, let's see, it's about 20 minutes. Oh man, that's awesome, bro. Hell, 20 minutes? That's what I'm talking about. You ain't got to go far at all. Yeah, he's leaving now. He's leaving now. There he goes. We got room, all kind of room for empties now. I could bring six empties in here. Six empties. Heck yeah. So who's in the chat? Good afternoonish to you. What time's it getting to be? 11? 11 something? Okay. Man, I'm fixing to get off watch. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Come on, Robert, just pivot off that barge you're next to, man. Does he need me to help pull him out or something, or what?
Robin,
you get a minute,
would
you tell me the engine hour so I can get this
clock caught up, please? Hey, Scotty, you on one?
All right, let me look.
Is your line 1-1
full? Thanks, bud. Okay. Starboard is 19883. Elizabeth, come on, man. You need to come on so he can get his barge in here. Damn, bro. You know what? Hold on a minute. Yeah, how about you, Willie Richardson? If you want, you can come up to this, where this Scott camp is. They got plenty of room there. You can get on the bow right here if you want.
Okay, is that what you want me to do? I'll work with you anyway, or try to get in
some more
down here.
Yeah, come on this way, because the boat did it the other day. He had like 6 foot under his boat right there on the bow end. So yeah, I'll back up and come over here.
All right, sure.
We're going to put him over here. Fishing poles out, and what do you use for bait? Well, when I'm on watch, I have to stay up here. My 6 hour watches, I have to stay up here. And when I get off watch, I'm usually ready to go to bed. We do use shrimp or mullet. We can use cut mullet here to fish with. And one of these days, I will do a fishing stream. I'll fish. When I'm off, I have to do it when I'm off watch. So I have to do it on a day when I'm rested up, because I'll be up for 18 hours if I do it. Because I got to pull my 6 hour watch, and then I'm off for 6 hours, and then I got to pull another 6 hour watch. So one of these days I'll do it I can do it on probably during the day, so like noon to six. I'll get on one of these barges here and try to catch something.
Hey, Robert, have a good one, man. John's worked too hard.
All right, man. You have a good one. You're heading to Houston?
We got you around Lake Charles.
Oh, going to Lake Charles. I got you. They got redfish here, speckled trout, white trout, drum.
Inbound, DC Greer.
Can we just cast from the wheelhouse? I mean, you're not leaving the wheelhouse then. Ha! I guess I could. Just cast up here from the wheelhouse. I tried fishing here a few times. I didn't have much luck. It kind of gets discouraging. They take your bait. They want to steal your bait. The little fish get a hold of it first and steal your bait. Them some bitches. You gotta hold your mouth just right or you won't catch the fish. Just right. Come on, computer. Come on, signal. Come back in. All right, I think we're back. Let me know when you get it touching there, landing, and then I'll push it. I'll pin it. Whatever. One of them words. It's one of them words. See, I don't want to push on him until he gets it touching himself because... might hit kind of hard. Pretty freaking good. I ain't gonna lie. I didn't even feel it touch. I didn't even feel it. That was good, man. You all pro, you make it look easy pushing the barges around. I've been doing it a minute. We've been in this fleet a whole year. And I guarantee I've probably had my hand in moving around at least 1,000 barges. At least 1,000 in a year. And then, you know, but I've been doing this for, I've been working on boats as a captain for 34 years. So if I can get 16 more years out of it, man, I have to call that a career. That's a career right there. Alright, so I'm fixing to do watch change. He'll be up here in about 10 minutes, maybe 5 minutes. I'll get all this stuff picked up here. Let me see. We have 16 viewers over on Kick. Let me see who we can find on Kick to send a host to. Always, even if it's a few, I like to send a host anyway. Uh, Carving. WS Wood Carving's over there. Yeah, WS Wood Carving over on Kick. There we go. That looks good. Gifted a... Oh! Slim Pickin' gifting a sub to Portland. 1,000. Thank you, Slim Pickin', for that. You're too kind, Slim Pickin'. You are too kind to my channel. To our channel. You are so kind, man. With the Slim Chicken. Can we get a Slim Chicken emote out there? For Slim Chicken? Where's the Slim Chicken emote? There it is. Fishing Solo's on. There we go. I haven't seen Fishing Solo in a while. Let's go check out Fishing Solo. Fishing Solo. There we go. Alrighty, so everyone, thank y'all so much for hanging out. Thank you so much for the gifted sub, Slim Pickin'. I hope I did that right. Up. And maybe we'll come on tonight if we're not, if we're doing something good, well, I may come on tonight. So thank y'all for everything, the support, and I will see y'all soon. All right, y'all have a good day. Rest of y'all day. Be safe out there, and y'all have a good one.